But since this area has been so unkind to us, I don't want it to take too long. I feel like already the Great Plateau has been taking too long. Oh my god, there's more of them. Come on, get them out of here. There you go. I think I'm doing at least an okay job at combat, minus the parts where I'm getting killed. Which, I'm gonna argue, are not entirely my fault. Here, catch. Alright, it didn't work all the way. But it worked some of the way. Yeah, eventually that stuff will burn away. That's just a club, I don't care about it. And then it'll poof and cease to exist. Same thing can go with food if you're not quick enough. I'm deliberately not healing because we're close to our shrine, and if you can survive the shrine, you get a full heal for just being you. So, if you can help it, try and wait sometimes for shrines, and then you can just get an easy heal that way without having to use any of your own items. There's a bunch of different ways to save your own ass when doing this. Down? What the hell are you doing right there? Oh, that was a very considerate landing. Is this not the thing I thought? What are you? Old with dime? I'm hoping you're the right one. Because I remember being on top of the mountain. But you're very clearly not on top. Okay, yeah, this is one of the things I needed. So stasis was something I wasn't particularly keen on. But when you learn how to use it, it becomes like the best thing in the game and one of the most fun things in the game. Stasis is also what helps me learn how to see what's around me, because basically if it exists, you can play with it with stasis. It's kind of complex to explain. But basically what it does is it freezes time, but it can also build up energy. So for example, if we go ahead and freeze this gear, it'll stop the platform from moving. That's no big deal. You know, something you'd expect. You can also turn it off on your own whenever you so choose. Let's see if we can go quick enough. Stop the ball so it doesn't come near us. Turn it. Go ahead. Yep. It shouldn't drop one as long as that one's going, so we should be okay. Yeah, hopefully it doesn't land on us. There it goes. I want that shield. I don't actually want that shield. That's not that good of a shield. I mean, it's better than that. That's just not as good as I thought it was. Yeah, because mine's 10 and that's only a 4. I just thought it was going to be something way better. We can go back to the spear. I want to keep that there just so it doesn't end up outrunning me. The little cooldown thing is kind of what sucks. But here's another example of how it builds up force. So each time I hit it, it's going to maintain energy. And then when it releases, it'll move forward. That is a good way to make objects fly. We already got our chest. So, like, it has its uses, and it may not seem clear at first, but sometimes stasis can be, like, the thing that will make or break you. this guy out real quick. What are you holding? Traveler spear. Well, I can handle that. Where's the other? Oh, hi. You don't want to hit the dude's head? All right, well, here's another secret. Excuse me? Excuse me? Just shoot him in the head, and that's usually all it takes. Like, any shot is enough to do it. Now, how the hell we're going to... Actually, no, I think there's a secret right under there. So this is one of those things that, like, I caught myself in the how I'm bad at everything thing. Because it turns out what you needed to do was stasis. But I didn't understand that at the time. So, like, I'm going to do so much better once I get there. Traveler's bow. We want to go ahead and switch our bow out this way. Get rid of it. And now we can go ahead and use that spear. But basically, anything that exists has the ability to be frozen in time. This sucks. Also, I'm surprised my cold resistance lasted this long. We gotta find another way to get around here. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and give this one a little bit of commentary just because it's a minute long. So, this will be kind of the way it normally plays out from here on out. Unfortunately, on my screen, it's like really choppy, so I'm going to need to clean this computer up, so this way at least it looks good at 3x speed, because that's the current plan. It just, like, the amount of ground gets covered a lot better this way, I feel, and I do feel bad at the idea of, like, especially after the bomb trial, it just feels like there's so much wasteful time bullshit going on that I had the feeling to just do it like this and just start fast-forwarding it and try and make the last area go by a little bit quicker, because admittedly I think we spent a little bit too much time on the Great Plateau. I was hoping we'd get it done in like an hour, but it ended up taking us about 2 hours with some failures here and there. But the fast-forwarding's about to stop.
Knock him out.
Oh. Go ahead and take that off your hands for you. Take this too. Now, why I climb slowly opposed to jumping is because it is better for your energy that way. He can go to hell. I'm out of here. I just need to try and find a way to get up higher so I can get around to where I need to get around to. Okay, he wants to come back. And if I can get that club from him, that's also going to be good. I'm out of cold! Oh god, this sucks. I don't have any way of doing it. I'm gonna have to leave. Shit. Yeah, no, there's like, I was hoping I was gonna stumble across a fire, but I got nothing. I gotta warp out of here and start all over. Right? Unless... Nope, that's still too much. Alright, take two. Take two is in second post-combat tape, but not in second recording. But, I decided to try and look around, see if I couldn't find some place to cook. Admittedly, my memory's not all the best as far as what all I was thinking. Alright, looks like I put a waypoint for the fire. Yeah, because I remember getting distracted by a little thing of smoke, and I was like, what's going on right there? And then I went to investigate that. Now, there's a cabin I've been trying to find, but I can't seem to find it. So, eventually during the next session, I'm going to make it a goal. Decided, you know, it's important to fast-forward this stuff so this way we can show you things like the extra frogs that you can find in the grass, and then, in this case, the inclusion of meat. Okay, it's only him. Alright, well, this'll work, because I've been eating a cooking pot, so... I'll let him sleep. Still not the area I was hoping to find, but it'll work. So, fast-forwarding stuff again, but I think you guys understand now why. It's just been taking longer than it needed to, and that's just where I'm kind of getting fed up right now. But anyway, let's go ahead and cook a bunch of these peppers real quick, try and get ourselves out of this. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll cook like 5. I do want to take this one moment to mention this, and that is because during this part I pick up a bit of bee honey. During my exploits, there haven't really been an easy way to grind for bee honey at all. So you really kind of just have to remember which points you find them, so we can tell you there's 2 up here, but there's no real easy way to grind it. You just gotta kind of like leave, come back, and then maybe it'll be there, teleport around, that kind of stuff. That's your best bet. Well, they found me. Oh, I can't wait till I get that upgrade. Oh, crap. Hold on. Get out of here. That works. Also, there's special attacks you can get for being, like, good. Like, if you parry at the right moment, or you can have a perfect dodge with flurry attacks. So it does reward skill, which is quite nice. But not this fool out. And then take your guys' food, because you don't need it. I don't see anyone. Ow! That really hurt. Just bob and weave, man. Can't even hit you. Alright, let us grab this treasure and then. I'm trying to head to the shrine, believe it or not, I am. I'm just, like, trying to find my way around this place and, like, always stumbling across a bunch of stuff. That's basically kind of like a summary of this game is, like, ADHD. Like, you're like, okay, I'm gonna do this, and then something else catches your attention. Yeah, it's just the nature of the beast. You can also use bombs to take care of those, but in my experiences, they tend to fly around, and since I got a perfectly good axe, might as well take advantage of it. What is this? Cobblin parts and more arrows, good. I want to say there was like, I think actually that right there is a Korok. But I don't really care. Which way are we going? This way. Yeah, I don't care. See, I knew this was an area, so I figured, alright, fuck it, might as well knock this one out, too. Switch back to our sword. Yeah. Look, as long as they don't knock over the tent, we're alright. Okay. Maybe a little bit less alright, but you know what? So are you. There. That didn't feel so good now, does it? What do we have that we can go ahead and eat real quick? Which, yeah, you've been seeing me pick up new items and stuff, like, hoping it's alright enough. Excuse me, that's not what I want. There's so much fire. Who's even left? Can I just take it? Like, there's no one here to stop me. Sounds like there is, but I'm not seeing anyone. Alright, so in this instance, we're just kind of like climbing up, going around, because that's the best thing to do. There is a little Korok puzzle we're going to come across. It's pretty simple. Hopefully, even at 3x speed, you can understand what's going on. It'll be up in just a second. That's just because it's like, well, I saw it, might as well. Like, I really should be trying just for at least some of it, because it will make my life a lot easier to have extra weapon slates. It's right up there, actually. You'll see a bunch of stuff like this just hanging around, and pretty much the idea is to mimic one side with the other, and then poof, you get a little seed like that. So, when I do like a little last round of the Great Plateau, I'm going to try and see if I can't catch a couple Korok seeds just based off of observation or memory alone, so that's my initial goal. But you see how slow this climbing is, and you understand why I thought to myself, this is such a bad idea. Like, I suppose you could argue immersion, but I argue efficiency. Alright, not working. But these twats out. I'll take that from him. We'll go ahead and use it against him. Oh, he's out of here. I'm not going that far. Which, yeah, you can go ahead and stun lock them after enough hits at their shield. You don't really gotta feel bad. I mean, there are better ways to do it, but... Oh, now you're just being stupid. Oh, that was beautiful. Did you see him fly? Because I did. Here's another shield for us, another pot for us, too. Let's see if we can go ahead and break this stuff wide open. Wow! Try again. That's what I want to see. I want to see it break. See the stuff on the floor, but apparently there was stuff on the floor. Now you can break it like that, it's just I don't prefer to if I have a choice. Okay, so maybe stasis isn't good enough yet, but it definitely will end up being. Alright, now we just gotta find a way to get over there again. As far as the music stuff that I'm doing here in post, I was thinking about making it kind of themed, like, for each biome, but I quickly changed my mind on doing something like that, so it's gonna kind of vary from place to place, but yeah, it's just right now these two songs for this episode, and then it'll change, so you don't gotta worry about hearing it all the time. I just thought it'd be fun to do something like this instead of just dead silence the entire time. Yeah, it looks safe. Which, yes, that metal thing is kind of hard to deal with, but after fighting with it enough, I get it to work. And so there's supposed to be a Korok down there. God damn it! But again, I accidentally go into the water when I don't mean to do it, and that's what ends up getting me killed, so... Frozen water is kind of the bane of your existence, and there is a point where you're actually going to be required to go into frozen water and survive. Like, there are points where it kind of forces you to have a whole bunch of health and then literally just take the damage. So, yeah, that's going to be a fun time later, but yet again, more wall climbing. The important thing is this is actually the last of the bullshit. I'm hoping we might be able to get this all down into just one video if I'm lucky. They have tent down there. Alright, you know what? No, but it's about to warm up here in a second anyway. I can't believe it took us this long to finally reach up here. Oh yeah, sometimes they can also throw each other. It's kind of fun. You'll get to see some of that. Excuse me, put that away. Oh, there was tint. Just... Oh, it feels so good to finally, like... No! To finally be like, yes, we're about done, because honest to God, I'm getting tired. And it's like... This is the kind of thing that it's only because I'm, like, aggravated with how long this has just been taking, but you know what? Once we get this... section done, we'll be done for the day. Let's go, Link. Alright. Last power-up. Right, yeah, because this is the fourth one. This was always so fucking hard to do. So this one's also a really cool one. There was a lot of times where I found myself using this to get around, And it's super slow-paced as well, which is also more the reason why I'm like, yeah, if I ever do this, I think fast-forwarding is probably going to have to be the way I LP this game. Don't worry about that last bit. That last bit doesn't do anything. Although there is actually some... I don't know when I'm going to get it, if I get it, or how I do it. But there are special things. So, Cryonis is basically just the ice rod. Simple enough. And then you can do it for stuff like this. If it can... It didn't look like it was forward enough, which is why I was questioning it. Let me just do that. He seemed mildly annoyed. Here you go. This is what I was looking for. Now, there are certain treasures that are, like, a little bit more specific that, like, you're gonna want in some of these. So, like, I know a lot of them have been kind of meh. But there are some really good ones, like clothing, that you're gonna want to get in certain areas. I don't think it really matters which one you do. Either one's fine. This just balances out both ways. It's just which way do you feel like going, left or right? Because you're going to the same place, same destination. I guess if you're a speedrunner, the choice is right. Oh yeah, you can also only have like three of them, so see how that dude's right there? It breaks when I bring up a third. But I can also choose to break them on my own accord as well. Yeah, that's everything around here. See, like, it wasn't so hard. It was just a pain in the ass to get here. But I hope it also makes sense why I'm doing things the way I'm doing things. I just kind of am upset that I had to break my own rule to myself. Yes. This you've acquired all the spirit orbs from the shrines of this place. Oh, extraordinary. Means it's finally time. Link, it's time for me to tell you everything, but first... Imagine an X on your map with four shrines at the endpoints, the final spot where those lines intersect. The middle. I shall wait for you there. Do you understand? Where two lines are connecting, the shrines would cross. I didn't get to read the last line. Now, go ahead and do this a little bit closer. I don't know how cold this water is, but I know I need to hurry up and get out of here, like, now! Jesus! Oh my god, so many times! This fucking water, dude! You fall in by accident, and then 2 seconds later, you're dead. Well, let's try and make a count. All I care about... is if we can just make it to that chest quick enough, we'll be alright. Because when you pull it up, the chest comes with it. Link, if you do not get your shit together, I will beat you. Kick it open. Was that so damn hard? Now let's bounce out of here. We need to go to the Temple of Time. That's where they intersect. The Temple of Time.